Hey, today I want to talk about a film called The Long Goodbye. It is directed by Robert Altman and it's released in 1973. It's based on a novel by Raymond Chandler, who many of you may have heard. But Raymond Chandler has made his name by actually writing books on hardboiled detective stories, pulp noir, neo-noir, that kind of thing. So, this is actually one of the last Raymond Chandler books to be actually adapted. This got adapted after he died. And this the main protagonist of this film and also the book is Philip Marlowe. Now, Philip Marlowe is a famous character as he has been a staple of pulp magazines and pulp stories that Chandler wrote dating back to, I think, in the 50s. And Humphrey Bogart actually portrayed this character in The Big Sleep to very much critical acclaim, and I think many people actually only know Philip Marlowe as Humphrey Bogart. Now, I have not seen that film, or I haven't seen Philip Marlowe being played by Humphrey Bogart, but I've seen this film, and in here Philip Marlowe is played absolutely brilliantly by Elliot Gould. That book was based in the 1950s Los Angeles, and Robert Altman sort of updates it in 1973 Los Angeles, and I think it just flows. I didn't even know that there was any break. Now I know that Raymond Chandler couldn't have written this story, and of course it was updated, but the way he portrays, Robert Altman portrays Marlowe is different from how Raymond Chandler portrays Marlowe, and in that way I think this film is actually kind of brilliant. For one example, Philip Marlowe in here is chain smoker, and by chain smoker I mean chain smoker. In almost all the scenes that Elliot Gould portrays Philip Marlowe, he's actually smoking a cigarette. Now, this film is actually sort of a kind of a chill, relaxed crime noir, because Philip Marlowe gets into some things with his friend, and as the story progresses, things become unfolding and some things become more complicated. But what I like about this film is that through this whole journey, Philip Marlowe is just very chill. And I think a lot of people have also compared it to Big Lebowski, both being set in Los Angeles and played by very chill and kind of laid back protagonist. And I don't think a lot of people actually got that in that era, because we have been accustomed to much more hard-boiled suit-wearing detective. Now, albeit Philip Marlowe does wear a suit, but he's a very different kind of suit wearer. Now, as far as the film goes, this film is actually really good, and in recent years, many people have even gone on to say it's one of the best Philip Marlowe and Raymond Chandler adaptations ever. And this has almost not a cult following, more like mainstream appeal too. The Long Goodbye is actually currently a quite big film and hit in certain audiences. In that way, there's nothing underrated about this film. But it was underrated when it came, and Robert Altman was significantly let down by the reception and how public was seeing this film. And in that regard, I think I owe it to talk about this film in this day and age. And if you see this film in 2020 and upwards, I think this film still holds. You get what Altman was trying to do. There were some quippy dialogues, and Elliot Gould absolutely shines. I cannot stress this enough. He's excellent in Philip Marlowe. For me, now this is what Philip Marlowe embodies. I know how Humphrey Bogart might actually portray this character, but I have to see it to just kind of think of it. For me, Elliot Gould is end all and be all for this character, because I think this is the type of detective that you do not get in a noir film, or do not get much in any of the genre films that you see in that era or even in modern times. So I think this is a very good film. I think this film has good characters, but though most of the characters do not have that kind of depth, or they're just there for Philip Marlowe to poise through, but the film is good. And this film score is actually done by John Williams, so you know the score is really fantastic. And this film is very fun. I would say it's definitely fun, even though one particular scene, Robert Altman put it, that was not in the book, to get back us into the reality of the scene, where he wanted to convey that even though his Philip Marlowe might be laid back and chill and thing might be happening in a very, you know, casual way, but he wanted us to remember that the world is not casual and it's still violent. So in that way, I feel like this is a really good film. And as far as neo-noir or noir film goes, I'm gonna give it a solid 4 out of 5. And if you are any kind of fan of the genre, I believe you should check it out.